Right now at 6, Coast Guard crews are working to move an oil tanker that slammed right into the Sarah Long Bridge on the Maine, New Hampshire border this afternoon. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The tanker broke free from its mooring at the New Hampshire State Pier and hit the bridge around 1:30 this afternoon. The Sarah Long Bridge is closed to traffic while tugboats try and move that tanker. News 8's Paul Merrill joins us now live from Kittery with the latest on this. Paul?
Tracy, they've made some pretty good progress moving this thing away from the Sarah Long Bridge just in the past 5 or 10 minutes. Take a look. They moved it out. They're in the process of turning it about 90 degrees from where it once was. Important to tell you, there are no reports of any injuries or leaks of the oil this thing was hauling. Over the past 90 minutes, we've been watching those tugboats moving around, and the tanker was clearing water from the ballast on its port side. You can't see that side right now because they've since turned it from the direction it was facing. The tide was high here just after 4, and it's going back out right now. Now, this tanker is 473 feet long. It's called the Harbor Feature, and it flies under a Portuguese flag. There were reportedly 20 crew members on board when this thing arrived in New Hampshire. It's carrying an unknown amount of tallow oil, which is basically animal fat. No reports of any leakage, but the Coast Guard says the tanker's crew is reporting a 6 to 12 inch gash above the waterline, but no water leaking in at this point as far as we're being told by authorities. We talked with a guy from Elliott, Maine, who says he was driving across the Sarah Long Bridge when the tanker hit it.
When I was coming up, I could see the superstructure of it, the bridge, and I could see the smoke, the black smoke coming out of it, and you could tell how close it was to the bridge. And as I'm going over and going slower, I can see the superstructure getting closer to the railing, and I was pretty much right even with it right when the But it wasn't a hard hit, but you could tell it was like hitting the bridge because you could see the ship, like the stern end of it in, and then it's, you know, the tide kind of pushed it up closer up to the bridge as it was going.
Back live now here looking across the river from Kittery, Maine, to Portsmouth, New Hampshire. It looks like those tugboats have stopped moving this tanker, but over really 10 minutes, they moved it away from the Sarah Long Bridge and turned it 90 degrees, put it back toward the direction of the New Hampshire State Pier, where it was originally moored this morning when something happened and it broke loose. Now, there are 3 bridges connecting Maine to New Hampshire in this part of the state. We have the Memorial Bridge, which is in the process of being replaced, so that's been closed for months. The Sarah Long Bridge, which is closed since this happened this afternoon, leaving the only way across the Piscataqua River right now is the bridge that's over I-95. No word yet on how long it will take crews to inspect this bridge, make sure it's safe before they can reopen it to traffic. That's the latest live from Kittery. Paul Merrill, News 8.
All right, thanks, Paul. And today's tanker accident, it's just the latest trouble for that bridge. Back in January, a mechanical malfunction caused the bridge to be stuck in the open position. The bridge had to be shut down for several days to traffic both on the road and on the river. The bridge is scheduled to eventually be completely replaced. Construction starts in the spring of 2015.